Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's take a look at the Go menu in the Finder. A big thank you today to all the people that make MACMOST possible through its Patreon campaign. You can find out more, join us, and get exclusive content by going to MACMOST.com/Patreon. So it's possible to use the Finder to get to your files without ever having to look at the Go menu, but there's a lot of useful functionality in there. So here I have a Finder window open and I can use the Go menu to change the location of that Finder window to point to somewhere else. There are all of these different shortcuts here that allow you to go to different places. For instance, if I wanted to go to my Downloads folder, I could simply select Downloads and it changes the location of the current Finder window. There's a lot of different locations in here. You've got Documents and Desktop, and this is sensitive to whether or not you're using iCloud Drive with Documents and Desktop turned on. If you're not, they're going to take you to your Documents and Desktop folders in your home folder. If you are using iCloud Drive with this feature, then it will take you to those locations in iCloud Drive. So for instance, if I select Desktop here, you can see it now has selected the Desktop folder under iCloud Drive. I could also go Home, which takes me to the Home folder, and in this case, since Documents and Desktop aren't there, they're in iCloud Drive, you don't see them there. But you do see other common folders like Music, Movies, Pictures, etc. You can also go to the main computer level, and this takes you to the top, which shows you your main hard drive, also any other external hard drives. You could also go to Network, which will show you any network drives. You can go to AirDrop, which will open up the AirDrop window so you're ready to receive something from someone. You can go to your main iCloud Drive level there so I can see my Desktop folder, my Documents folder, but also other specific iCloud Drive folders if I have them. You can also jump to your System Applications folder. So this is really a variety here of locations because some of these are in your Home folder or related to your user account. Other things like Applications will actually take you to the System Level Applications folder, as well as Utilities, which takes you to the Utilities folder inside of the Applications folder. Notice these all have shortcuts. So if there's something here that you need to get to often, you can simply memorize a shortcut to get there. You also have access to the Recents folder. The Recents folder isn't really a location on your drive. It's basically a search that's returning results showing the most recent files that you've accessed. Notice I have it under Favorites here as well, but sometimes you turn that off. You can go to Finder, Preferences, and under Sidebar you can turn off Recents, but that doesn't mean you can't access it using the Go menu or that keyboard shortcut. Now there's one that's missing from here that you can actually add by using the Option key. Hold down the Option key and your User Library folder appears. So this isn't the System Library folder, but your User Library folder, and you can go there. So if you're ever told that you need to access something in your User Library folder, go with the Option key and then choosing Library is a quick way to get there. At the top of this menu we've got Back and Forward, which have keyboard shortcuts for Command and then the square brackets. And you can use this like a browser window. You can keep going back or you can go forward through the locations that you were looking at in the Finder. You can also go to Enclosing folder. So for instance here, if I were to go to my Documents folder, I could go to Enclosing folder to go up a level, in this case to iCloud Drive. So you can do that at any level. I can go Documents and then into Projects, and then I could do Go and Enclosing folder or Command up arrow to just keep going up the hierarchy. Now note, if you don't have a Finder window open, what happens if you choose one of these is it opens a Finder window. So Go Documents will open up a Finder window. That only happens if you don't have an existing window open. Otherwise, if you've got a bunch of Finder windows open, using Go will take you to that location in the current Finder window. Now you also have a Recent Folders submenu here, so you can jump to the last 10 places that you were at. And then you have something that's a favorite of a lot of pro users. They love this shortcut, Go to Folder or Shift Command G. This brings up a little field that you could type in and select any location on your drive to go to. So in this case it chose the last thing that was there and I can hit Go and it jumps there. You can use Shift Command G to quickly access this and then start typing right away. And most of the time you're going to want to access something that's in your home folder. In that case you don't have to type /user and then your home folder name. You can do tilde, which on US keyboards is the Shift key and then the key right above the tab, and then /, and then put the name of the folder. So if I wanted to go to Pictures, for instance, I could go that way. You also have a list here of recent folders that you've gone to, so it's really easy. And if you wanted to dive into a folder that's in the current folder you're at, so for instance if I'm in Documents and I want to go into this Samples folder here, I can do Shift Command G, I can type Samples, and it will go down into the Samples folder. You also have the ability to connect to a server, Command K, which allows you to type a server address and using a prefix like VNC for screen sharing. And then you can also just hit Browse right there to jump to browsing your network. One final trick, if you use the Go menu and you hold the Shift key down, you'll notice in Closing Folder changes to Select Startup Disk. Shift, Command, and then Up Arrow is the shortcut for that. So this will take me, in this case, to the Macintosh hard drive. So it's basically the same thing as going to Computer and then choosing your startup disk, but in this case it chooses the startup disk right away. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.